and the love they brought into our lives.
Oh, I'm so grateful, God, you know you did the most. When you created her for me, Lord, you know I have witnessed your glory, all this favor you showed me. When you gave it to me, I had to learn what to do with your blessing. Now I know that a man who findeth the wife finds a good thing. So every time I think of her, I'm thinking you. And when I give my love to her, I'm thinking you. Loving her like Christ led a church, 'cause you told me to. Yeah, she a missy on your glory. Sometimes I don't feel like I'm worthy, but I'm under your covenant, so I ain't worried. I'm just thinking you. When I think of her, I'm just thanking you. When I give her love, I'm just thanking you. Married and in love, I'm just thanking you. You. When I think of her, I'm just thanking you.
It's good to see all of y'all. The couple wanted me to remind you that each of you are here because you're family. Not all by blood, but by love. The couple welcome you and extend their sincere thanks to each of you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to celebrate a milestone in their lives. 40 years. Somebody will say amen.
Amen.
You know, some people stay together a year, they go. But 40 years of holy matrimony.
Amen.
We thank God for that. Let us bow our heads.
Heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day,
yeah,
our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. For lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory
just a few minutes. And if she holds her finger up, that means
cut it.
But I want to say 5 minutes is that Clint nor my sister asked me for any consultation as far as a preacher like to ask a couple that's getting married or renewing their vows a question. And the question is, now pay attention, walk with me on this, in paraphrasing, is God in your house?
Amen.
Now, if they don't understand what I mean, I got a problem. A preacher never, or should not, I don't, marry a couple if they're not unequally, if they're not equally yoked. Don't come to the church and say, I won't get married in your pretty facility around all your glory, and they don't believe in Jesus Christ our Lord. I know for a fact, they didn't have to consult me, because I've seen their lives play out. My mother adopted Clint. I hate him for that. She saw something in him. Her name, she fixed his plate before mine. And I knew I was in trouble. But I think my mama realized when she met Clint Lowe, that he was going to treat her daughter like she ought to be treated. Because she discovered that he believed over there on Ohio Street that he was indoctrinated with one beautiful fact, that you got to have God in your house. He can't be on the outside. You can't wait for him to come in when you're in trouble. He got to be in your house 24/7. So I come here not in a consultation. I did ask you, Faith, about if you still thought God was in the house after 40 years. Oh, Clint could have got on your nerves. Clint, I didn't ask you. But as a preacher, I observed. When I come down, the children, and let me say this as I hush, because Faith about to hold that finger up. When I walk in their house, they have done a marvelous job because God was in the house. They got diplomas from the University of Science everywhere. They put in the effort because they want their children to walk in God. Right. Now, if I ever had the opportunity to marry one, I don't know, because you know they like these hip hop pastors now who can jump over the people. I can't jump over the people. I need some resuscitation. And some compensation. She got the finger up. But I want y'all to do me a favor. I want y'all to give God the thanks for 40 years and give them the glory, because God has been in their house for how long?
40 years.
And I advise all these children up here as an evangelist of God, that if you're going to get married in God's house, make sure you know, you say they hung him high, they stretched him wide, he bowed his head, and for me he died. They put him in the bar of tomb, and early on the third day he rose with what kind of power?
All power.
God must be in the house.
Amen. From the moment that I wake up,
we're now in the session we have this renewal. As I said, I didn't consult them because I knew they are in God. So at this time, Clint and Bobby Faye, I remind you that marriage is a special gift, a lifelong dedication to love and a daily challenge to love each other more fully and more freely. With this understanding, Clint, you can't buy it now, I'm finna tell you something. 40 years, if you stay where you at. With this understanding, do you, Clint, continue to take Bobby Faye as your beloved wife while reaffirming your eternal love and devotion to her? Clint, will you continue to be a tender, faithful husband? Will you continue to love and cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer, for poor, for better, for worse, and keep yourself only unto her? If soul saves, do save.
Yes, sir. I will continue to love Bobby Faye Lowther. I will continue to provide for Bobby Faye Lowther.
Amen.
And I will continue to protect Bobby Faye Lowther.
Right.
In Jesus' name.
All right. Amen. Amen. Yeah, that's not in the script, but I told you, I'll say that. Yeah. That's my son. Yeah. Yeah. With this understanding, Faye, you have no choice after a man say that. With this understanding, do you, Bobby Faye, continue to take Clint as your beloved husband while reaffirming your eternal love and devotion? Will you continue to be a tender, faithful wife? Will you continue to love and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer, for poor, for better, for worse, and keep yourself only unto him? Your reply.
I do.
Faith said Clint said enough. At this time, we're going to have the Holy Communion by Reverend
Violet, rolled up in one for this precious moment that we have today, 40 years. It was said on that night, on his betrayal night, at the conclusion of the feast of the Passover, that him and his disciple was celebrating. It is said that he took bread, having blessed it. The bread represents his body, his broken body that he shed for us on the cross. And it was said on that same night that he took up the cup, which is symbolic to the blood that warms in his body for the remission of our sins.
Amen.
And they did take it. And we know the bread is symbolic because he said, this is the bread that came out of heaven, not of the bread that our fathers ate and died. Whosoever eateth this bread shall have everlasting life. And we know that the blood is symbolic to the remission of sin. Apart from the blood, there's no remission of sin. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this moment that this couple has opened up unto you, understanding that God, that you are the anchor of their relationship. And we continue to pray that God will give them 40 more years of blessing. Let love reign supreme in their house. And may they always manifest themselves to good character, conduct, courage, and commitment to each other. Yes. If they continue to live on this journey. In Jesus' name we say, Amen.
Amen.
Bobby Faye, having witnessed your vows of affirmation with all who assemble here, and by the authority of love itself, I do affirm that you have expressed your desire to continue as husband and wife, reaffirming your eternal love and devotion for each other. Let the church say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Now this last part here, Kent, you may kiss your bride on the cheek.
Oh, that was impressive.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct honor to present to you once again, as husband and wife, Clint and Bobby Faye Lowthers. Let the church say amen. Let us stand as they walk out, amen, and give them the praise for what they've done through God.
See?
Thank you. awesome day it has been on today. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice in and be glad in it. We thank and praise God for the beautiful couple of Clinton and Bobby Faye Lowther. Come on, let's give them a hand at this time. Known Bobby Faye ever since high school, over 40 plus years ago, and I found out that she and Clint met each other in the second grade. Can you believe that? Second grade, Clint had eyes for Faye. Wow. I have watched them just grow and mature, and their love just grow even more together. 40 years later, look what God has done. Yeah. Three handsome sons, one beautiful daughter-in-law, one potential daughter-in-law on the way, seven beautiful grandchildren. We know that was nobody but God. And so at this time, we salute Faye and Clint for what God has done. For he has declared, when a man findeth a wife, he findeth a good thing. And I do believe with all my heart, Clint loves Bobby Faye Lowther. And I know Faye loves her Clint. So at this time, shall we toast?
You're here.
Thank you, folks. Say good evening. It's going good evening. I'm not going to be before you, honored, just to speak on behalf of my brothers and grandchildren and things of that nature. I guess I was fortunate. I was the one that was fortunate enough to just be around. As I look out, I see you all, and you know, my mother told me not to tell my age, but. At the big age that I am, I have to realize that I was around 40 years ago. And just to see each and every one of you all in not at a funeral home is very, that's very, very, very good.
Yes.
Because the last couple times I've come home has been funerals.
Yeah.
And I don't want our family reunions to be, you know, surrounded by funerals and deaths. But this is the most joyous occasion.
Yes.
I see my grandmother over here, and at this point, at this age, I love, she doesn't know this, but when I go home now and see her, I record her voice. Mm-hmm. And I replay those. And yes, Grandma, my dad. But one of the things that you told me a long time ago, and I tell people now, you said that, baby, I'm rich. Mm-hmm. And I understand exactly what that means. Because this is an example of being rich.
Yes.
And as a son, son doesn't forget. I'm just proud to have grown up in this house, to see them go through the things that they've gone through. And my dad always tells me, he says, son, when you get through something, it's going to be something else.
That's right.
And it has. And they have stuck beside me in good and bad. And they've always shown up in love. Mm. Like each and every time they've shown up in love and help and the things of that nature. That's what family is.
Yeah.
Family is something that you cherish. Family is something that you hold on to through good and bad. Yeah. My mother told me a long time ago, you'll be able to count your friends on a couple of fingers.
Mm-hmm.
And I truly know this, but family, I tell them a lot of times, I feel like I hit the lotto as far as family's mm-hmm. concerned. I look out and I see my uncles, you know, they all have their hair for the most part. That means like I'm keeping the hairline. You know, we've been through some sickness, we've been through some loved ones that are no longer here. And I think it's important to celebrate the thing that matters most, which is this family. So I pray for my parents, I pray for my brothers, I pray, you know, for their significant others and my nephews and my niece and my children. So I just want to say thank you all for coming. Thank you for celebrating this level of love. And as a son, I'm just truly, truly, truly thankful to call you all parents. And I wish you continued success and love in each and every aspect of your life. Thank you.
It's been a long time. today. But I am just so grateful for this day. 40 years ago, we was doing this same thing. I never imagined that we would be doing it again. I didn't want to get married again.
I understand.
My wife told me that this would be a good occasion. It's not a sad occasion. We're waiting to pull the family together. I said, well, I'm all in. Because I tell you, since I've been retired, I feel like I've probably been to over 50 funerals.
Yeah.
From 2016 up to 2024. And people are leaving this world every day. For this last month or so, one a week or two a week. And you could probably go to one every day. But that's how God is moving. And I tell people all the time, we need to live in the moment that we're in. Because even the next second is not guaranteed. But you got this moment. So live in it. But I just want to thank everybody for coming. I thank my lovely wife for putting up with me. We kind of put up with each other. There are a lot of times I just fall in line. I take on the concept of Eli Ellington Sr. When he's heard enough, he just he shut down his hearing aid and keep it moving, and it all works out. So I'm just truly blessed to be in a family of love. So glad to have my mom here. She told me that she's here. She was with us 40 years ago, and if God was willing, she was going to be with us 40 years later. So she's here today. She's a patriot of our family.
Oh,
yes. Patriot. Yeah, that's it. And I love her. That's so much I can say. I know y'all are tired. Some of you got to get back to your places. We don't have to go to work no more. Thank you. But I'm going in the morning. But it's so good to see all of your faces on a good occasion. And I'm just so thankful that we have friends. He said two fingers. I know I got probably 10 good friends that I can count on. I can call them now, and they'll come to my rescue. And I'm probably sure that a lot of you do too. You know somebody who will come to your rescue. But most of all, as Reverend Ellison always said, keep God in the house. It works.
It works.
I'm here to tell you, it works. And you keep him in your house, and at the center of everything you do, the result will come out in your favor. I'm here again. Love all of you. Thank you for coming. And I'm still working my way around the room to get to some of my people. Well, there's some rams and some noobs in the house. I hadn't got a chance to break bread yet. Yeah. Okay, but I'm working my way, guys. Thank y'all for coming.
But when I was doing the planning for this ceremony, at the heart of it was family. At the heart of it was love. And so all of you are here. Handpicked, because we love you so much. We appreciate the joy that you bring to our lives, and we're so glad that you're here. And we want to continue to celebrate family, celebrate love, because it's important, as Clint was saying, we believe in every day. So we need every opportunity that we have to come together, we need to come together in love. So 40 years ago to this day, at the exact same time, 3:00, my husband and I said, I do. And that's why we didn't have it on Saturday. We wanted to have it on the day of the 40th year. And I do want you to take an opportunity to walk back to the fireplace back there the mantle and see those pictures from 40 years ago. Some of you are on those pictures, or in those pictures. So please, and there's a picture on the cake stand and a couple of others, but please take the time to look at those pictures and bring back some memories. Happy memories then, and we're gonna have happy memories from this occasion. We love you all so much. I cannot say enough that it's all about love. And as my mother taught us, love is a verb. That means you must do something. You can't sit around, hold your hands, you know, put your hands behind you and say, I love you when I'm struggling, or you struggling. There's something you gotta do. And then even if I'm not struggling, show love every day in some way. We can do that every single day, and it's very important. So we love you, we thank you for being here, we are honored to have you here, and we just appreciate you coming. So thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts.
I was trying to figure out